Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Come, let us worship God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and our God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. How beloved are the dwellings, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs and faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh have rejoiced in the living God. Even the sparrow has found herself a home, and the swallow a nest for herself where she may lay her young. Even the halters, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Blessed are they that dwell in thy house, and to ages of ages shall they praise thee. Blessed is the man who selfless from thee, for he has sense in his heart. In the valley of tears, in the place which he has appointed for the lawgiver, shall grant a blessing. They shall go from strength to strength, to God, God shall be seen in Zion. O Lord God, hold hearken unto my prayer, give you, O God of Jacob. O God, our defender, be bold and look upon the face of thine anointed one. For better is one day in thy courts than thousands elsewhere. I have chosen rather to be an outcast in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of sinners. For the Lord loves mercy and truth. God will give grace and glory. The Lord shall not withhold good things from those who walk without guile. O Lord God of hosts, blessed is the man that hopes in thee. Thou hast been gracious, O Lord, unto thy land. Thou hast turned back the captivity of Jacob. Thou hast forgiven the iniquity of thy people. Thou hast covered all their sins. Thou hast subdued all thy wrath. Thou hast turned back from thy fierce anger. Restore us, O God, of our salvation, and turn away thine anger from us. Unto the ages wilt thou be angry with us, or wilt thou stretch out thy wrath from generation to generation? O God, thou wilt turn and give us life, and that people should be glad of thee. Show us thy mercy, O Lord, and grant us thy salvation. I will hear what the Lord God will speak concerning me, for he will speak peace to his people, to his saints, and to them that turn their hearts unto him. Surely his salvation is near to those who fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth have met together, righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth has sprung out of the earth, and righteousness has looked down from heaven. For the Lord will give what is good, and our land shall yield its fruit. Righteousness shall go before him, and shall set his footsteps in the way. Incline thine ear, O Lord, and hearken unto me, for I am poor and needy. Preserve my soul, for I am holy. Save thy servant, O my God, that hopes in thee. Have mercy on me, O God, for unto thee will I cry all the day long. Make glad the soul of thy servant, for unto thee thou liftest up my soul. For thou, O Lord, art good and meek and abundant in mercy unto all who call upon thee. Give ear, O Lord, unto my prayer, and attend unto the voice of my supplication. In the day of my affliction have I cried unto thee, for thou hast heard me. There is none like unto thee among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any works like unto thy works. All the nations whom thou hast made shall come and worship before thee, O Lord, and shall glorify thy name. For thou art great and workest wonders, thou alone art God. Guide me, O Lord, in thy way, and I will walk in thy truth. Let my heart rejoice that I may fear thy name. I will praise thee, O Lord, my God, with all my heart, and I will glorify thy name forever. For thy mercy is great upon me, and thou hast delivered my soul from the nethermost Hades. O God, transgressors have risen against me, and the assembly of the mighty have sought after my soul, and they have not set thee before their eyes. But thou, O Lord, my God, art compassionate and merciful, long-suffering and abundant in mercy and truth. Look upon me and have mercy upon me. Give thy strength unto thy child, and save the son of thy handmaid. Work in me a sign for good, and let them that hate me see it and be put to shame. For thou, O Lord, hast helped me and comforted me. Work in me a sign for good, and let them that hate me see it and be put to shame. For thou, O Lord, hast helped me and comforted me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O Christ God, thou hast ascended in glory, granting joy to thy disciples by the promise of the Holy Spirit. Through the blessing they were assured that thou art the Son of God, the Redeemer of the world, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O thou who for our sakes was born of a virgin and did suffer crucifixion, O good one, who did despoil death by death, and is God to reveal the resurrection. Despise not that which thou hast created with thy hand. Show forth thy love for mankind, O merciful one. Receive the Theotokos who bore thee and who was praying for us, and save thy despairing people, O our Savior. Give us not a utterly for thy name's sake, neither break thy covenants nor cause thy mercy to depart from us, for the sake of Abraham, thy beloved, and for the sake of Isaac, thy servant, and the sake of Israel, thy holy one. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit in the hour of infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thy kingdom, power, and glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen. When thou didst fulfill the dispensation for our sake, and unite earth to heaven, thou didst ascend in glory, O Christ our God, not being parted from those who love thee, but remaining with them and crying, I am with you, and no one will be against you. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. O thou, whatever season and every hour in heaven and on earth art worshipped and glorified. O Christ our God, long suffering, great and merciful, deeply compassionate, who lovest the just and shows mercy upon the sinner, who calls for me to salvation through the promise of good things to come. Do thou the same, Lord, accept also our prayers in this hour, and direct our lives according to thy commandments. Sanctify our souls, purify our bodies, guide the right our minds, cleanse our thoughts, and deliver us from every affliction, evil, and sickness. Compass us about with thy holy angels that guard us and guide by their legions, that we may attain into unity of faith and the knowledge of thine unapproachable glory. For blessed art thou in the ages of ages. Amen. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim, remaining virgin, you give birth to God the Word, to their temples we magnify you. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
O God, be gracious to us, that lift the light of thy countenance upon us, and have mercy on us.
Amen. Master, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who art long suffering toward our sins, and who has led us into this present hour, in which, while hanging upon the life tree, to the wise thief thou didst open the gates of paradise, and by death to destroy death, cleanse us, sinners, and our unworthy servants, for we have sinned and transgressed, and are not worthy to lift up our eyes and look upon the height of heaven, inasmuch as we have forsaken the path of thy righteousness, and have walked after the desires of our own hearts. But we entreat thy boundless goodness, spare us, O Lord, according to the multitude of thy mercy, and save us for thy holy name's sake, for our days have been consumed in vanity. Pluck us out of the hand of the adversary, and forgive us our sins, and mortify our fleshly desires, that having put off the old man, we may put on the new, and may live unto thee, our master and benefactor, and that so following after thy commandments, we may attain unto rest eternal, where is the abode of all rejoice. For thou art in verity the true joy and exaltation of those who love thee, O Christ our God, and unto thee we offer glory, together with thy Father, who was without beginning, and thy most holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Blessed is our God,
as it were, garments, as covering the water shall stand on the hills. Have pointy feet, they shall flee at the voice of thy thunder, they shall be alarmed. They go up to the mountains, and down to the plains, to the place the thou hast found for them. Thou hast the boundless, they shall not pass, neither shall they journey in the cover of the earth. He sends forth his fountains among the valley, the water shall overleap in the mountains. They shall give drink to all the wild beasts of the field, the wild ass shall take them and to quench their thirst. By them shall the birds of the sky lodge, they shall have no darkness the rocks. He waters the mountains from his chambers, the earth shall be satisfied with the fruit of thy works. He makes grass to grow for the cattle, and the earth for the service of men, to bring bread out of the earth. And one makes glad the heart of man, he makes his face cheerful, all the bread strengthens man's heart. The trees of plain shall be full of sap, even the seed of the Lebanon which he has planted. There the sparrows will build the nest, and the house of the heron takes the lead among them. The high mountains are refuge for the stags, and the rock for the rabbits. He appointed the moon for seasons, the sun on this morning down. Thou must make darkness, and it was night, in it all the wild beasts of the forest will be involved. Evening and light, warm for prey, to seek meat for themselves from God. The sun rise, and they shall be gathered together, shall lie down in the den. Man shall go forth to his work and to his labor till evening. How great are thy works, O Lord, in wisdom as thou art, and all the earth is filled with thy creation. So is this great and wide sea, there are things creeping, innumerable small animals and great. There go the ships, and this dragon of thou has made the plan. Always upon the beginning of food in this season. When thou hast given it them, they will gather it. When thou hast opened thy hand, they shall all be filled with good. But when thou hast turned away thy face, they shall be troubled. Thou wilt take away their breath, and they shall fail and return to their dust. Thou shalt send forth thy spirit, and they shall be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. But the glory of the Lord be forever. The Lord shall rejoice in his works. He looks upon the earth and makes it tremble, touches the mountains, and then spoke. I will sing the Lord while I live, and praise my God while I exist. Let my meditation be sweet to him, and I will rejoice in the Lord. Let the sinners fail from off the earth, and transgressors, so they shall be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, in the new ages of ages. Amen. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. From above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Mercy.
For Metropolitan Tikhon, for Archbishop Alexander, for the honorable priesthood and the diaconate in Christ, and for the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For this country, its presidents, for all civil authorities, and for those who serve in the armed forces, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city and countryside, and for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord. For seasonal weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating O most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other in our life unto Christ our God. For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Lord, thou hast been our refuge from every who could measure thine anger, strength, and our awe? How measure thy wrath? So make known thy right hand to us, that our hearts be held fast in wisdom. How long, Lord, relent to thy servants be comforted? We were filled by thy mercy every morning, all our days we rejoiced and were glad. Gladden us for all the days that would humble us, for the years we saw only evil. Behold thy servants and thy works, give guidance to their sons, and let our Lord's splendor be upon us. Guide the works of our hands rightly for us, the works of our hands guide aright. He that lives in the help of the Most High shall abide in shelter of heaven's God, and shall say, Thou art my helper and refuge, O my God. I put all my hope in him. He shall free me from hunter's snares, from every terrifying word. His shoulders shall bend down over thee. Under his wings shalt thou have hope, his truth, a shield surrounding thee. Thou shalt not fear the night's terror, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the thing moving in the darkness, nor the danger of catastrophe. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come near thee. With thine eyes shalt thou be comprehended and see the reward of sinners. Thou, O Lord, art my hope, thou hast made the Most High thy refuge. No evil shall come close to thee, nor any scourge draw near thy home. For he shall put his angels over thee, and guard thee in all thy ways. In their hands they shall bear thee up, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread on the ass, the basilisk, thou shalt trample the lion and the dragon. Because he has set his hope in me, I will deliver him. I will shelter him because he has comforted my name. He shall call out to me, and I shall hear. In affliction I am with him, I shall lift him up and glorify him. With length of days I will satisfy him. I will show him my salvation. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the age of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorate your most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. And let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thine is the mind, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Lord, I call upon thee.
I cry to you, O Lord.
shout of the day through the grace of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, as we celebrate your divine and life-bearing memory, we honor with the love of ever
flock I gather. I will never
mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace. That the whole evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Grant this, O Lord, an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
Remembering our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God.
Lord,
thou art a good God, and lovest mankind, and unto thee do we send our glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And to your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
For thee, O Lord.
O Lord our God, who hast bowed the heavens, come down to the salvation of mankind. Look upon thy servants and thine inheritance. For unto thee, the fearful judge, who yet lovest mankind, thy servants bow their heads and submissively incline their necks, awaiting not help from him, but entreating thy mercy and looking confidently for thy salvation. Guard them at all times, both during this present evening and in the approaching night, from every foe, from all adverse powers of the devil, from vain thoughts and from evil imaginations.
Blessed and glorified be the might of thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Your two natures, you exalted me with yourself in each.
us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen.
Most glorious art thou, O Christ our God, thou hast established the holy fathers as lights of the earth. Through them thou hast guided us to the true faith. O greatly compassionate one, glory to
and more glorious beyond compare than the same.
Christ our God, and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
From us into heaven and sat at the right hand of God the Father, Christ, our true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, of the holy, glorious, and laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, Nicholas the Wonderworker, Archbishop of Myra and Lycia, and Saint Metrophanus of Constantinople, whose memory we keep this day, and of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, the protectress of this holy community and synod of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loves mankind.
Amen. His Beatitude, the Most Blessed Tikhon, Archbishop of Washington, Metropolitan of all America and Canada. His Eminence, the Most Reverend Alexander, Archbishop of Dallas and the South. This God protect the land, all civil authorities, and all of the Christians, reserve our Lord for many years.
Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory forever.
Just have a few announcements this evening. In about 15 minutes or so, we'll start the Zoom Bible study. Boom. Acts 6, probably hit a little bit of Acts 7, even though Acts 7 is lengthy. We'll be talking about St. Stephen, the proto-martyr and archdeacon. So please join us if you can. If you can't, then you're always welcome to see the recording that will be accessible on the website and through the weekly email. I want to especially commend to everyone's prayers, Nora Rathburn, who's newly born to Stephanie and Jason, as there are some complications going on right now, to keep them in your prayers. And within a day or two, there will be a link sent out for a meal train for the Rathburns as well. I think in general, instead of a little talk, since I'm going to be doing a Bible study for an hour, just a word of encouragement for prayer, especially this time, as at least in my lifetime, I'm used to, if there's a riot or something, it's something that happens in one city, and then in a day or so, it's kind of fizzles out. But we seem, for a host of reasons, some of it, I think, overboiling from COVID, overboiling from all sorts of other things that I think we're aware of challenges in our society, from racism to issues with policing, et cetera. We're just in a very difficult, strange time. So I encourage everyone to be prayerful and mindful about these things, especially, well, nobody saw anything like the Bolshevik Revolution happening. Not that I think that we're to that point yet, but nobody sees these things coming. So let's be prayerful. And always, something about this year and all of our prayers, where most of the time we're in the Latii during the vigil and we have these prayers for against famine, against plague, against civil war, against, and 2020 came along. And all of a sudden, all of these prayers have new resonance in ways that I've heard them for years, and now they get to have a depth of meaning that I never fully, in some ways not prepared for, but even aware that it would happen. We in America have been blessed in so many ways, and we can kind of lull ourselves to sleep, but here we are. So be prayerful, be vigilant, be as we pray for all those, as we said in the litany, for the civil authorities, but also for those who are sick, those who are suffering, those who have lost their lives on, I'm going to say either side of this, but on all of the conflict that is ensuing. We need to pray for everyone. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to God.
This weekend will be busy. We will have a Saturday morning liturgy, a bit memorial liturgy. Please send in your names. I've already been getting some emails for names to remember. On that evening, we'll have great Vespers. It will be live streamed. We'll also, on Sunday morning, we will have one baptism and a host of chrismations that will be occurring before the Divine Liturgy. This is all, of course, according to plan, that baby comes and everything is all good, basically. If there's a baby on Saturday evening, we're probably going to need to postpone. There will be Divine Liturgy. We will have Pentecost. It'll just be Father Stephen presiding, because I will probably not be able to be here, and we'll postpone for the next week for All Saints for all of that. There'll be a few others. I know the Hicks family will be receiving two baptisms and chrismation on All Saints of North America that morning, because they're not available for the next 2 weeks. So please be prayerful about them as well. Anything? Yes.
Speaking of babies, my niece Krista gave birth to the baby girl yesterday. Zolo will be her name, means sunrise.
Excellent.
All are doing well, too.
Good.
You are the pure one.